Query syntax, method syntax, mixed syntax. These are the three ways to write a LINQ query. But what does each one mean? How to write a query in each way? What is easier or better to use? When to use each one? Are these three ways the same or is there a difference between them? That's what we will learn in this video. Before start talking about the three ways, let's do a recap about LINQ. What does it mean and what are the requirements for a LINQ query? LINQ is to retrieve data from different sources and formats. So, it's to transform a data source to a new form, after doing some calculations or filtering the data. And query is a set of instructions that applied to a data source to perform certain operations. A LINQ query consists of these three parts: initialization, calculation, selection. Initialization is to define the data source from which we get the data. The data source could be a data table, array, list, XML file, data on SQL Server, or many other data sources. Calculation is the part where we filter the data, sort the data, or doing many other operations. Selection is to select the data after doing the steps before. We can select only one element or a group of elements. These are the standard parts of a LINQ query, but they must not always be set. In other words, not each query must have all these three parts. A query could have only initialization and calculation, or initialization and selection. It means, initialization must be available in each query, because it contains the data source, what we want to query. The output of a LINQ query is either IEnumerable of T, or IQueryable of T. If we are using enumerable methods in the query, the output will be of type IEnumerable of T. But if we are using queryable methods, the output will be of type IQueryable of T. To convert these types to a standard type, we can use conversion operators. For example, to convert IEnumerable of integer to integer array, we can use toArray method. And so on, we can use different methods to convert the output of the query to another type. That's all for now. Let's start learning the different ways of writing a LINQ query. The first one is query syntax. It's an easy way to write a complex LINQ query in a readable format. The syntax here is very similar to SQL query. We use here query clauses, what I showed you in the previous video, for example, from, where, select, let, group by, etc. The query in general looks like this one. From, where, select. We first have from clause. This represents the initialization of the query. Here we define the data source, which is the sequence that we want to query. The data source could be a data table, an array, a list, or something else. We can also use aggregate instead of from clause. It's also to define the data source. It means, at the first position we either use from, or aggregate. The second part can be where, or also one of the following clauses: group by, join, group join, order by, let. We can use one of them or also all of them. Each clause can be also used more than once. For example, we could have where twice, or let 10 times. And so on, we can use any clause of these after from or aggregate. These clauses represent the calculation of the query. There is no rule, which clause from these should be first, or in which order do we have to use them. It depends on our need, what we wanted using the query. We also must not use these clauses if we don't need that. It means, you can write a LINQ query without using these clauses. So, here we can filter the data, group the data, sort the data, or do something else. In other words, here we prepare the data before selecting it later. The last part is the selection. For that we usually use select clause. But we can also use one of these clauses: skip, skip while, take, take while, distinct. Here we select the data we need from the data source. It means, we get here only the data, which we still have after doing the calculations in the previous step. This is how does a LINQ query look like using query syntax. Let's try to write a LINQ query using query syntax, to understand it better. I have, for example, the following integer array, which contains 6 numbers. I want to filter this array to get only the numbers, which are greater than 5. Let's see how to do that using query syntax. As mentioned, we always set from or aggregate at the beginning. I will explain the difference between them later in another video. For now, I will use from clause. After that, I have to define a variable, which represents the numbers inside the data source. I will use the name number for example. After that, I have to write the preposition in. At the end, I will set the data source, which I want to query. In my example, it's the array. This statement is ready now. What does it mean exactly? This statement acts like for each loop. It's to loop all numbers inside the array. So, the initialization is finished. Or in other words, this statement is to define the data. Let's now move on to the calculation. As mentioned, in this part we can prepare the data, like filtering, grouping, ordering or something else. In my case, I want to filter the array. For that I can use the clause where. Where clause is to filter a sequence. I will talk in detail about this clause in another video. For now I want to show you, how to write a LINQ query using query syntax. So, I will set the clause where. Then I will write the expression to filter the data. I want to get only the numbers, which are greater than 5. I can do that using the following expression. As you see, I use the variable number, what I defined before to write the expression. As mentioned, this variable represents the numbers inside the array. This statement is also done. So, I define the data source at the beginning, then I filter the data. Now we still need to select the data. This can be done using select clause. So, I will use select clause, then the variable number, to select the numbers from the array. The selection will be only for the numbers, which are greater than 5. The output of this query will be the following sequence. As you see, we have only the numbers, which are greater than 5. This sequence is of type IEnumerable of integer. This is how a LINQ query looks like in query syntax. Let's now see, how does this query work step by step? At the beginning we have the variable number to iterate the numbers inside the array. In the first iteration, the variable number has the value 7. In the next step we check this variable, if it's greater than 5. It's greater than 5, therefore we move on to the next line and select this number. So, now we have the number 7 in the output. Now we go back to first line and check the next number. It's number 4. Then we check it, if it's greater than 5. It's not greater than 5, therefore we don't select it. So, we go back and get the next number. And so on, we iterate all numbers inside the array and select only the numbers, which meet the criteria. At the end we get only these three numbers as output, because only these numbers are greater than 5. This is how the query works line by line. That's all about query syntax. Don't worry if you don't understand everything now. You will learn everything in detail later, how to use each clause and also how does each query work step by step. For now it's important to know the query syntax, and also which clauses can be used here. Before I move to the next point, let me summarize query syntax for you. Query syntax is one of three ways to write a LINQ query. The syntax is similar to SQL syntax. We use a clause, then an expression to do something. We normally set from at the beginning and select at the end. Between both clauses we can only use the other clauses. Each clause can be used once, or also more than once, depending on the query we want to write. Let's now move on to the next point, method syntax. Method syntax is the second way to write a LINQ query. Here we don't use clauses, but only methods. Which methods? All methods under classes, enumerable and queryable. So, using method syntax we can use all methods we have in both classes. Let's now see, how does a query look like in method syntax? I will explain the syntaxes here also in the same way, as I did in query syntax. So, we have these three parts of a LINQ query. The order of these parts is as following. We always have the initialization at the beginning, after that we do the calculation, and at the end we set the selection. The different parts are separated with points. Let's now replace the parts with some methods, for example the following query, which is also the same like the query syntax, to filter an array and getting only the numbers, which are greater than 5. As you see, we first have the array, which is the sequence that we want to filter. After that I used where method, to filter the array. At the end I used select method, to select the numbers that are greater than 5. This sequence will be the output of this query. Let's now understand how to write such queries using method syntax. There are two important points you have to know about method syntax. The first one is that we always use lambda expression for each method we want to use. Like these two methods, where and select. I used lambda expression in both methods. So, we can use the methods only with lambda expression. The second point is that the execution of such queries will be performed in the same order as what we have in the query. It means we have first where method to filter the array. This will be first executed. After that we have select method to select the numbers. This will be executed after where method. We could have other methods before, between or after both methods. These methods will be also in the same order executed. In summary, if we have more than one method in the query, these will be executed after each other. Let's now talk in detail how this query will be executed step by step. First, I define the data source, what I want to query. In my example, it's the following integer array, which contains these six numbers. After that, I have where method with the following predicate, to filter the sequence and get only the numbers greater than 5. So, this part will be executed. The output of this part is the following sequence. This means now, that the following part of the query is replaced with this sequence. It means, I have only a sequence and the method select. The expression here is to select each number from the sequence. It means, I'll get the same sequence as output. It means also, that we don't really need to use select method in this query. But you will learn more about that later, and also how to use each method and how to set the expression for each method. For now, it's important to understand how a query will be executed. And that's everything about this way of writing a LINQ query using method syntax. Let's summarize these points. To write a LINQ query using method syntax, we have to set the methods after each other. The order of the methods is very important, because the execution of the query happens in the same order, where each method is written. So, depending on what you need to do using the query, you can set the different methods in the correct order, so that you get the correct result. We can use all methods from both classes, enumerable and queryable. To use any method, we have to use a lambda expression. That's all about method syntax. Let's now move on to the third way of writing a LINQ query. It's mixed syntax. As the name suggests, it's a mix of both ways, query and method syntaxes. It means, we use both clauses and methods to write a LINQ query in mixed syntax. For example, the following query. I will not explain the query. I just want to show you, how does a query look like in mixed syntax? Later in the course you will understand how to write such queries. As you see, I use the following clauses, from, group by, select. I also use the following methods, take, element at, copy to data table. So, we have clauses and methods in one query. This is how a query looks like in mixed syntax. In this way we can write a complex query in a readable format. By the way, this query is to remove the duplicates from a data table, based on one column called ID. That's all about mixed syntax. These are the three ways to write a LINQ query. Let's now check, which way is better to use, or which way can be used to write a specific LINQ query. There is no rule what is better or what should be used to write any query. But the first way, query syntax, is very limited because we only can use these clauses to write a query. So, we can do some steps but not everything we want. This way to write a query can be used only for very simple queries, where we have to do the easiest things, like filtering, ordering or joining. But once we want to write a complex query, we should use the other two ways, method or mixed syntax. In other words, these two ways can be used to write any LINQ query we need. Using both ways we can do exact the same. The only difference between both ways is the readability of the query. If we have a small query, it could be very easy to understand in both ways. But if we have a complex query, where we need to use many different methods, it will be easier to use mixed syntax. During this course you will see, how to write each query in each way. You will also see, what is easier to read and understand. So, you can later decide, which way you want to use to write a LINQ query. In my opinion, mixed syntax is the best way to write complex queries in a readable format. That's all about this topic for now.